For the next half hour or so, I'm going to take you through some of the major developments in the sector over the last 10 years and hopefully give you a flavour. I know a lot of you were around at that time and maybe it'll jog some memories for you. And for those of you that wouldn't be as familiar with the sector, hopefully it'll be a very informative presentation for you. Okay, so just to give you an overview first, we're going to look at yesterday as the first part of the presentation. And this will really be to look at the childcare landscape in County Donegal prior to 1997. Then we're going to look at the work of the Donegal Childcare Strategy Group, which, as you know, was the forerunner for the Donegal County Childcare Committee. Then we're going to look at the investment over the last 10 years. And then we're going to make some comparisons between yesterday and today. So really looking at the types of services and the types of numbers that we had maybe about 10 years ago compared to where we're at now after a 10-year investment programme. And then we're going to finish up with looking at a few key policy points which could be taken forward for keeping children on the agenda for tomorrow. Okay? Okay. So, the childcare landscape in County Donegal pre-1997, you were looking at that time at in and around 49 childcare services. And I suppose when we compare that now to almost 150 childcare services, it shows you how much the sector has grown in that very short time. People at that time, when they were surveyed, and I suppose to put a lot of this information together, we had to delve into the archives of DCC and look at some of the reports and documents that were recorded at that time. And really the general feeling at that time was an extreme lack of support. Basically, if you were a childcare provider, you were isolated. You were working on your own, and due to the large geographical size of County Donegal, this only added to the problematic nature of that, because providers really were on their own. And it was reported at that time that levels of quality were really up to the individual service in terms of what they deemed to be quality and what level of quality that they had in their service, because this would have been pre the preschool regulations. At that time, there would have been an advisor from IPPA, and the Northwestern Health Board at that time would have had a number of community workers who lent their support to childcare providers as much as they could. And there was a small annual grant available from the Northwestern Health Board for community groups on a yearly basis. Just as a matter of interest, for anybody that was around at that time, can anybody remember what the grant was? Francis, no? No? It was a couple of hundred punt at that time, you know. Say again? 200 raised to 500. So you can imagine what you could do, how little you could do with that today. Thanks for that. Okay, so as Martin alluded to earlier, a meeting took place in March 1997, and this was with the view of putting together a childcare strategy group that would have all agencies in the county working together to promote the childcare agenda. That was officially formed on the 11th of July 1997 through the support from an EU support programme, Peace and Reconciliation, and also with some support from the Northwestern Health Board. So a partnership approach was central even at that time, and if we compare that to what we're doing now in terms of we're still working through the County Childcare Committee with partnership representation. And I think that's one of the key messages when we're reflecting back on the last 10 years is that no organisation can do this on their own. And I suppose there's always a danger when you have a countywide organisation like Donegal County Childcare Committee operating in the county that other agencies would think, well, childcare's up to them, they are childcare. That can't happen and it doesn't work. We need all the agencies to be involved and we need every agency to have a childcare policy and a childcare agenda and to make sure that this partnership approach continues. So the legacy of Donegal, the Donegal Childcare Strategy Group, the establishment of the County Childcare Committees in 2000 resulted in the role of the Childcare Strategy Group being subsumed into the new County Childcare Committee. And under the national government policy assigned at that time, the local component of the development of a coordinated approach to childcare was seen as being central. And of course, the model that was put forward, or that was, you know, the approach that was used by the strategy group, the partnership approach, was very much used then when devising the model that would be used for the County Childcare Committees nationally. Okay, so building the infrastructure mainly took place between 2000 and 2008. And of course, a lot of you will remember, particularly any of you that would have had capital portfolio submissions in the May 2008 round will know that the programme was supposed to continue to 2010. And I mean, nobody was more disappointed than we were when it was prematurely exhausted in 2007. The last project that was funded was actually 2007. Because we thought this programme was going to run for another 3 years. So as Martin has already alluded to, I mean, we still have significant gaps in the county, and we still have areas, and I'm thinking particularly of the Anishinaabe region, that doesn't have appropriate childcare. So the two programmes that we worked with during that time would have been the Equal Opportunities Childcare Programme and the National Childcare Investment Programme. And the total funding that came in from both those programmes came to almost 30 million. So although it's a major investment for a county like ours, we still have a wee bit to go. And this slide just shows you, regarding the capital funding that went into each electoral area. You'll probably see it on your handout there a wee bit clearer. But it just breaks down that the Anishinaabe region would have had about a 10% slice of the pie, if you like, over those 7 or 8 years. Letterkenny had 18%. The Milford electoral area had 7. Stranorlar, 23. The Donegal area, 14. And Lenti's, 28%. So that just gives you a wee flavour of how the capital funding was actually distributed. So since the expiry of the capital fund in 2008, a number of funding schemes have been developed to sustain early years care and education. And all schemes are now administered locally by Donegal County Childcare Committee. And just to give you an idea of those type of figures, the National Childminding Development Grants Programme has brought in over 73,000 and almost 74,000 to the county. The Community Childcare Subvention Scheme, although it's only been running from 2008, has made a contribution of almost €4.5 million to the sector. The Early Childhood Care and Education Scheme, which again, we're only in our second full year of it, has brought an investment of €10.5 million to the county. The National Parent and Toddler Initiative has brought in almost €22,000. And the new Childcare Education Training Support Scheme, the SET scheme, has brought in €1.5 million to date. So if we look at, first of all, you know, community services, you're looking at 44 community services compared to 82 now, so an increase of 86% in community services. Private services, 26 and 65, so an increase of 150% there. So that's probably representative of the capital investment programme for childcare providers. I mean, I think at 10 years ago or prior to that, we had a bulk of community services. They were the usual type of service. The childcare service type, we have an increase of 255% in full daycare services now compared to what we would have had at that time, and an increase of 83% in sessional services. Okay, but the significant increase would be in the purposeful premises that we're using for childcare. Another interesting one was the employment statistics and the qualifications. In 2000, there were 70 people working on a full-time basis and 160 people working on a part-time basis in the childcare sector. And that has now grown to 326 full-time and 373 part-time. So we now have almost 700 people working in the childcare sector. It's a major part of our economy here in Donegal and shouldn't be underestimated in terms of how we can contribute to the economy and the importance of that particular role. And I suppose it's also interesting to say out of that 699, 698 are women. I just thought I would throw that in. Okay, and regarding qualifications, accredited qualifications in 2000, and this would have been people who at that time would have had the equivalent of a level 5 or above. And at that time, that was just 6%. Whereas now, it's 77%. 72% of people in 2000 had no recognised qualification. And when we say no recognised qualification, what we mean by that is, you know, a number of people would have had, you know, short introductory courses maybe in play and in child development and this type of thing, but they weren't actually accredited qualifications. They were usually delivered by the likes of IPPA and, you know, some of the training organisations at that time. And no qualifications at all. Has remained, funnily enough, in and around the same, although, of course, the numbers would be significantly higher now of the people that are actually working in the sector, so it's not exactly relative. And now to move on to child places. In 2000, we had 275 child places, whereas now, full-time child places, whereas now we have 780. So that's an increase of 184% in our child places in the county. Our sessional and part-time places, we had just over 1,000 in 2000, and we have over 3,000 now, an increase of 215%, and overall an increase of 209% in terms of the number of places that we can offer to children in County Donegal. Children with special needs was another interesting one. We found a survey that was completed by the then Northwestern Health Board, I think in 1999, which surveyed all the preschool settings at the time and asked them how many children they had attending with special educational needs. Now, I have to point out that this 22 is not the number of children in County Donegal at that time who had special educational needs. It was merely the children who were attending the childcare services at that time. And our latest census, which was completed in 2010, the DCC annual census, asked you the same question, basically. And if for any of you that filled in the census form, you will remember that question: how many children do you have in your service with special needs? And that figure has now come back at 211. So I think that figure is not to be ignored. And it definitely strengthens one of the points that I'll be making later about the need for investment for special needs assistance for children in the preschool services. And now some visual images for you. This kind of gives you an idea very strongly and visually of where we've come from and where we are now. And thanks a million to all the childcare services who delved into their own archives and got us some photographs for this piece. This is a photograph of one of our local services, Drumkeen Community Childcare Centre, and you can see the before and after there. The after being a multi-purpose, specifically designed childcare service. The next one is Convoy Community Playgroup, which again is one of our recently opened centres, and you can see the type of building that they have come from and where they are now. And if you think about that, I suppose, from a child's perspective, the difference of walking into the first premises and walking into the second premises, it's absolutely remarkable. And then we have Bauchan Community Childcare Centre in Inishowen. And again, you can see their first premises, which was an old national school, and I'd been in it quite a few times, and it was extremely run down, to where they are now, again, with their multi-purpose centre. And finally, our DRA. And this is only a sample. We have many more of these throughout the county, but this is just a flavour, as I say, to give you a visual image of where we've come from. So that would be Ardra Community Childcare Centre. So today in County Donegal, there are 147 childcare facilities. We're proud to announce that we have a 97% uptake on the ECCE scheme, and this is compared to the 94% national average. So if anything is a testament of how parents have embraced the importance of preschool provision, that has to be it, because we're sitting at 97% uptake and we're hoping to bring that to 100% very soon. And currently we have 780 full-time places and 3,348 part-time places across the county. So now that we're fortunate enough to have a full Minister for Children and indeed a spokesperson for children who is located here in the county, we have for the first time dedicated leadership on children's issues. And we need to use our voice to influence that at every opportunity. We need future thinking and policy for children to be planned, joined up, and ambitious. And yes, we are in the centre of a recession, but that doesn't mean to say that we can't plan for the future and we can't be totally ambitious about what we want for our young children. And remember, children can't speak for themselves. There's a lot of lip service being given to the child's voice and how the child should be included in decision making. At the end of the day, the strong voice has to come from us as their adult representatives to make sure that we provide the best opportunities possible for them. And one of the things that I want to point out is, in spite of recommendations from OECD, the Oireachtas, the NESF, and the social partners, Ireland has no long-term national plan for the development of early childhood care and education. This has to be rectified immediately and should be one of the key priorities from our new minister. A national childcare plan for the next 10 years is required alongside a successor programme to the National Childcare Investment Programme. And that's crucial if we're going to continue that infrastructure development that we have started over the last 8 years, and to make sure that the gaps that are still remaining are closed. It's essential to maintain the current level of expenditure on services and supports for children and families, and the progress that we have made just can't be lost. Recent developments, again, as Martin has already alluded to, have been the free preschool year. It's essential that that is something that remains and is never jeopardised, because I suppose it was the first positive step towards doing something universally for children. And planning for tomorrow, the free preschool year should be extended to a second year. And in the short term, we believe it's achievable for the second preschool year at least to be available for children with additional needs who are not in a position to begin primary school. Because some children, by their stage of development or by their individual need, the one preschool year does not fit. So in the short term, at the very least, if we could get that extended for children with additional needs. And we've seen the figures. We know what the early childhood sector are working with in terms of the numbers of children with additional needs in the sector. So that would go a great way to addressing that and to helping that situation. In addition, the new government should align the preschool starting age with that of the preschool year in order to ensure that no children miss out on their free preschool opportunity just by the age they are or the month in which they were born. That needs to be rectified. And again, funding for special needs assistance is urgently required to ensure the equality of participation for children with additional needs. Because again, we use the words equality and inclusion and all these things very, very loosely. But until we get to a stage where we can put our money down and say, well, yes, we are doing something about that for children with additional needs, again, we're paying lip service to it. We need to invest in the early childhood workforce. And although it's very easy to get carried away when we look at some of the fantastic services that we have now in the county and we're thinking, you know, purpose-built premises and all these wonderful things, that's not the job done. The physical environment, such as space and resources and outdoor areas, is only part of the quality picture. The true quality lies in the interactions and relationships between children and staff. The educator's ability to effectively engage with young children and to build those fundamental relationships and cement the learning dispositions so necessary for future life require a skilled, professional early childhood educator. So to address that, there needs to be a dedicated training fund to support educators to reach graduate level status and a minimum 3 days annual in-service training as part of participation on the ECCE scheme. We know that we struggle to get people to attend events like this, and it's not because they don't want to. It's because they don't have professional development time built into their year. They're afraid to close because it will, you know, it will affect their finances. It's absolutely ridiculous that a sector charged with such an important job doesn't have professional development time built in. So we need that training fund. We can't expect people to do it by themselves, and we need the professional development time. Early childhood educators should have the training, status, and development opportunity of other professionals. The FETAC Level 5 qualification that's required to participate in the ECCE scheme is well below the graduate level training that is advocated for service managers and leaders internationally. So we need to move that graduate level workforce forward. And quality. Quality sometimes, and I'm speaking here from my own opinion and perspective, is a very overused buzzword. We get latched onto it and we get carried away when we see the word quality. It's true that we've come a long way by developing our quality framework, Sheelta, and our curriculum framework, Ashter. But until such times as these frameworks are embedded into appropriate funding supports, they will remain no more than a vision, and a very nice vision at that. The principles put forward by both frameworks will remain visionary until such times as they're fully embedded into the training of the early childhood workforce and also to the inspection process. We have the tools now. We need to stop looking at what other people are doing and trying to change what we're doing. We need to use the tools that we've had developed for children in the Irish context. And we need to put the support packages behind those for their full implementation into the sector. It's unfair just to give a sector a couple of documents and say, there you go, away you go now, read that, and the next time we come out to see you, your service will be just spot on. Totally inappropriate. In addition, a large proportion of the early childhood sector remains unregulated. Plans need to be put in place to regulate both the childminding and the after-school sector. And in addition, it's essential that all those who support the delivery of quality services, including staff and training organisations, tutors, facilitators, preschool inspectors, and those working in the advisory roles, for example, the County Childcare Committee, have a minimum third level qualification in early childhood care and education and experience of working with young children in the sector. That's crucial. So in conclusion, when we're thinking about an agenda for young children going into tomorrow, how many more times do we have to read that the early years are fundamental to the child's future well-being, development and life chances? How many more reports will be commissioned to tell us what we should be doing or looking at what they're doing in other countries and, you know, comparing us to that? How many more pieces of research do we need to tell us that Ireland is not investing sufficiently in its future and most important citizens? And most importantly, how many more children will no longer be children by the time we get it right? Thank you.